Please rest on your back. Have your arms and legs long. Take a moment to observe how you rest on the floor and shift your attention out of all the thinking and the planning and all the analyzing that we have to do to get through the day. And move your attention into sensing. And in particular, sense the shape of your low back at this moment. Is it a little lifted off the floor, and is it uncomfortable or strained? If it feels uncomfortable, bend your knees and stand your feet. Part of the learning in this method is how to take care of ourselves and how to feel comfortable. It's often something we neglect in our daily lives. Return to the low back and observe, could you slide a penny under there, or a marble, or a golf ball? How do you sense your spine on the floor today? Do you feel 80% on the floor, or 50% on the floor, or some other percentage? What's your subjective impression of length from the pelvis all the way up to the base of the skull? We're just taking an inventory without judgment, without fixing. Just notice how it is at this moment, and it will change as we go through the lesson. Notice where your arms are today. Are they on the torso or next to the torso or far away? Are your fingers straight or curled? And take a moment to observe your face and the pressure between the lips, the eyelids if your eyes are closed, the tongue inside the mouth. Allow there to be space inside the mouth so the teeth are not touching and the tongue is resting and the back of the throat is open and free. And just remove any sense of presenting yourself for a social situation. And you can enter into your internal space. Bend your knees and stand your 2 feet on the floor. So the feet are a comfortable distance apart, not close together. Make a movement of drawing the abdomen in and tilt your low back into the floor so the tailbone lifts slightly, and then let it go. Completely let it go. And do that movement again and notice if there's any tension in your jaw as you start to draw the abdomen in. Can you do this without tensing your jaw or your throat? So all you're doing is flattening the back, bringing the small of the back into the floor, and releasing it. And the releasing it is just as important as the doing. Reduce any effort, not in the toes or the fingers, the eyes. So you only do what's absolutely necessary. And continue this movement. Can you feel movement in your spine? Can you feel movement in your neck as you do this movement? Pause with your pelvis resting. Make a movement of lifting the low back and push your belly forwards and increase the arch of the low back so the weight travels to the tailbone and then release that. And then do it again. Roll toward the tailbone and make the same assessment of what's happening in your jaw, What's happening in your throat? If there's any extra tension anywhere, it's going to inhibit the movement of the pelvis. Notice what your eyes are doing. Can you feel how the pelvis pulls the spine as you do this movement? And something may happen all the way up the 24 vertebrae into the head. Can you feel that it pulls the chin closer to the throat and straightens out the neck vertebrae? And then as you roll back, the chin bobs back to the starting spot. Right? The neck comes back to its original shape. And then go both directions, drawing the back into the floor and lifting the back away from the floor. And this is a small, easy, light movement. And make it a rocking motion in both directions, coming onto the tailbone and then coming onto the low back, the lumbar vertebrae. Without clenching the jaw, I cannot emphasize that enough. The skull is free to move at the top of the neck. The eyes are free to move in the eye sockets. Go so slowly you can feel the pelvis pulling all 24 vertebrae and then pushing into all 24 vertebrae. Observe the chin. Pause a moment. Rest your pelvis in the neutral position. And grit your teeth so that the lower teeth are held against the upper teeth. And now rock your pelvis. Can you feel it's not as clear, not as easy, not as fluid? Release that constraint and allow the teeth to be separated in the mouth and continue to rock your pelvis. And pause a moment with the pelvis in neutral and lower the legs and rest flat. And notice if your contact with the floor is different. Imagine that your pelvis is resting on the floor on a clock. And 12 o'clock will be where your tailbone is, and 6 o'clock will be up at your low back. And the easiest way I've found to help people visualize this is to imagine that there is a clock on the wall that your feet are pointing to, right? So your feet are pointing towards the wall, and imagine a clock on that wall, and that a magic clock, and it can slide down the wall and then slide across the floor and land under your pelvis. And in that instance, you can feel that 12 o'clock is at your tailbone and 6 o'clock is at your low back. 3 o'clock is to your right and 9 o'clock is to your left. Visualize the clock. Actually visualize the numerals, the color, the size of the clock. Bend your knees and stand your 2 feet. Tilt your pelvis diagonally to the right towards what would be on the clock 1:30. And then come back to the center. So it's towards your right knee, towards your right foot, and then come back to the middle. Right, so it's halfway between 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock. And feel what you have to do in your low back to make this organization, right? You're arching your back, but you're not going straight down toward the tailbone. You're going slightly to the right, towards your right hip, towards your right knee. Notice with this slight complexity, do you hold the breath or clench the jaw? Can you find a way to make this movement just as fluid and familiar as the other directions? Come back to the middle, pause. Tilt your pelvis diagonally to the left now, towards your left hip. So your belly button goes a little down but to the left. Go gently. If you have any strain in the low back, you want to make this a very small movement. On the clock, this would be about 10:30. Feel what you do with your shoulders and your upper back and your ribs as you do this. Pause after each movement, so you release the engagement of your muscles and then you re-engage. In your own experience, is going to the left easier or is going to the right easier? The next time you do the movement, observe your head. Does it do something similar? Pause a moment in the middle. Tilt your pelvis to the right in the direction of 130, and then come back to the middle, then go over to the left in the direction of 1030. So you're making a little arc. And go back and forth like this, softly and gently. And pause in the middle so you can reset yourself. And then go to the other direction. Feel the arc. Feel the breathing. Feel the line your pelvis draws on the floor. You can move your attention around as you do the movement. It's not just about performing the movement, but feeling what happens in your ribs, your throat, your shoulders. How do your shoulders help or not help? What side is easier for you? Let it go. Lengthen the legs and rest. Has anything changed? How do you contact the floor? Bend your knees again. Have your feet standing a good distance apart so they're comfortable. The feet are under the knees. Tilt your pelvis directly forwards towards 12 o'clock. And stay there. Feel the pressure near the tip of the tailbone. And from that point, roll your pelvis to the right in the direction of 1 o'clock. And then to 2 o'clock, over to the right. And then to 3 o'clock, more to the right. And then return along the same arc to 2 o'clock, to 1 o'clock, and back to 12 o'clock. And repeat that 1/4 of a circle very slowly. This is not something you want to rush through. Feel the contact between your pelvis and the floor. Really identify each hour. So you go to 12, Then you go to 1 and to 2 and to 3. And then back to 2, back to 1, and back to 12. And the mission here is to make the movement smooth and round so that it's not clunky or staccato. And let go of tension in the shoulders or the jaw. And I'll give you a clue for this lesson. Allow the ribs to move. There is no rule that says you're not allowed to move the ribs. The legs in this movement are upright. They're not tilting. So you articulate the pelvis. Rest your pelvis in neutral. Tilt your pelvis toward 6 o'clock, toward your low back. Your abdomen is drawn in. Your low back is close to the floor. Roll your pelvis to the right to 5 o'clock, to 4, to 3, and then reverse it to 4, to 5, to 6. So you're visualizing the clock, and you go back and forth between 6 o'clock and 3 o'clock with the mission to make it round and smooth. The rounder and smoother your pelvis is, the more supple and fluid your spine and your ribs become. Can you even feel those hours? Because at first when you do this, they can be very elusive. Which numbers are clear? Just doing that 1/4 of a circle. Come to the middle, rest. Lower the legs long, and notice any differences in the weight of your pelvis on the left and the right. Bend your knees, stand your feet. Push your belly forwards and come on to the tailbone end of the pelvis at 12 o'clock. And notice if you can breathe in this position. Roll your pelvis again to the right, to 1, to 2, to 3, and then past 3 to 4. And past 4 to 5, and then to 6. So now your low back is pressed into the floor. And go back again to the right, to 5, to 4, to 3, to 2, to 1, to 12. And continue that half circle, pressing each hour of the clock. And observe other places in yourself where you might be tensing. So the movement is a kind of test to see if you have any kind of effort anywhere else in the system. What happens in your jaw? Do you focus your eyes really strongly on the ceiling? Because when something is complex, we often focus our eyes. Or add tension somewhere else in the system, as if adding tension will alleviate the complexity. So the skill here is in identifying each hour and making the movement really round. And observe the size of your clock. If it's too big or too small, sometimes it's hard to really, truly, honestly feel the hours. Pause, let it go, lower the two legs, and rest flat. Now feel the two sides of yourself. contact the right leg makes compared to the left leg. Right side of the pelvis compared to the left side of the pelvis. And then more globally, the whole right side compared to the whole left side, including in that your face, left and right. Bend your knees, stand your feet. Find a comfortable place for your feet, really supported under your knees. Push your belly forward and come to 12 o'clock on the tailbone. From 12 o'clock, go to the left, just to 11, and then to 10, and then to 9, and then back around to 10, to 11, to 12. Go really slowly. Then change your strategy and go just 1 hour, just to 11 o'clock, and then back to 12 o'clock. And can you feel if that 1 hour has an arc-like shape? Go back to 12 and to 11 many times, just arcing your pelvis, not clenching your teeth. And then continue and go to 10, and then go to 11, and then to 12, and then back over to 10, and make that an arc. Make it really clear. Now go all the way over to 9, so it's a quarter circle, and then return to 10, to 11, to 12. Go back and forth, keeping the feet flat on the floor and the knees vertical, so you're not tilting the knees, that's a constraint. The pelvis is moving in between the legs, in between the hips. When you go over to 9 the next time, go to 8 o'clock. And then return to 9, to 10, to 11, to 12. And then back to 11, 10, 9, 8, and back to 9, to 10, to 11, to 12. And it's a funny paradox, as you go through these hours, if you allow the movement to happen, or do less, or try less, I know it sounds funny, but it actually allows you to articulate the pelvis more fully. The next time you go around to 8, go all the way to 7. And then back around to 12 o'clock. And then return to the left, making a semicircle now all the way down to 6. And then reverse it to 7, to 8, to 9, to 10, to 11, to 12. Go many times to the left, filling in each hour and listening to yourself. Listening to your jaw, what happens in your head and neck. Can you feel the arc and the roundness of the circle? There's a true roundness, not just a clunky roundness or a half roundness, but the more round you make it, it really will help you articulate the pelvis relative to the hips. It'll help your spine be supple, your ribs wake up. And sometimes we get stuck in a particular size of the clock, and you can adjust the size. Maybe your clock is a watch. Get really clear about the left side of the dial, each numeral, almost like you could press it and then come off it and press the next one, and then off it and then the next one in succession. And then pause a moment, lower the two legs, and rest flat. Please bend your knees again. Have your feet really under the knees so you feel supported. Tilt your pelvis forward. Push your belly forward so you're at 12 o'clock. From 12 o'clock, go to the right again to 1, to 2, to 3, and continue around the clock in a clockwise direction, down to 6, and then keep going to the left to 7, to 8, to 9, and then up to 10, to 11, to 12, and continue around slowly, making the circle smooth in a circle, an actual arc, so that it's not a bent bicycle tire. It's not clunky. And I will say again that this has something to do with your ribs and your spine and your head being free at the top of the spine. Freedom in the pelvis is connected to freedom in the rest of you. And can you observe where you are at any moment in time so you actually kinesthetically know where your pelvis is oriented in space? Feel how the spine moves in between the shoulder blades. And the constraint here is the knees stay vertical. Reverse the direction and go counterclockwise to the left, slowly, monitoring the arc, monitoring each hour. And the trick here is how much of yourself can move, not how isolated can you make the pelvis. I can guarantee you, anybody who has back pain does not move their ribs. Come back to this idea of finding an hour which is unclear or has some resistance around it, and again, roll your pelvis a little in front and a little behind of that hour, like 1 hour on either side. Reduce the effort, make the movement smaller. Sometimes smaller helps, sometimes changing the size of the movement. Sometimes bigger helps. So you adjust how your back is moving, how your shoulders are responding to the movement. And once you've made that smoother, then keep going around the dial. And maybe you see another place that needs some attention. And go back and forth. And then let it go, lower the legs, and completely rest. And now feel the contact your left side makes and the right side. The quality of your breathing. One of my metaphors for learning this kind of thing is when we have a drawer that is, let's say, a wooden drawer, not the kind of drawer that's on runners, but when a wooden drawer is stuck, one of the strategies is to pull harder, and often that makes it stick more. But if you shift the direction of the drawer, you can jimmy it out of its stuck position. So very similar to Feldenkrais, you don't want to push harder against a stuck position. Adding force to something that doesn't move is not a positive strategy for learning. So continually alter your strategy and find other places in your system that can help move or wake up movement. Bend your knees, stand your feet. Do the movement in a clockwise direction. And find out if you can make it a little faster without a sense of hurry and without adding anxiety, simply changing the speed with the same degree of circular motion so it doesn't become too wonky. Of course, it's not as precious and careful as the slow movement. I'll give you a clue. You're allowed to wiggle. The knees still stay vertical. That's a constraint. Go in the other direction. Go in the counterclockwise direction and keep the smoothness and keep the roundness, but make it faster. Very soft, very quick, and very light. And I'll repeat that you are allowed to make yourself wiggly, soft, supple. All of the joints of the ribs and the spine respond to this intention of the pelvis. Pause in the middle and simply tilt your pelvis forwards towards the tailbone and backwards towards the low back. Go back and forth and notice the connection between your pelvis and your head. What happens in your chin? One of my comments to my clients is that Feldenkrais is like couples counseling for the pelvis and the head, so that they can have a conversation. And notice if that conversation for you through your system feels clearer, more friendly. Then slowly let that go. Lower the legs and rest flat. Scan your contact with the floor. Feel the low back, the ribs, the shoulders, and what percentage of your spine is on the floor. I suggest coming back to this lesson on other occasions and find out how you experience it, because it will be different every single time you do it, and you'll change your strategy every single time you do it. This is a lesson I myself come back to many times to help keep the spine and ribs and pelvis supple, fluid, and supportive. When you're ready, roll to the side and come to sit and come to stand in a way that's respectful of your comfort. In standing, simply rest on your feet on the floor, not on your mat. And feel how your bones support you and how your weight drops down into the hip joints, into the knees and the feet and the floor. And walk around and notice how this affects you as you go through your day. Thank you.